out the guy who invented the whole concept, Brian Veith. What a great weekend for you to see this all come to fruition.
Yeah, these guys are not only good golfers, but they're student athletes, and they're great young men, very respectful. And I felt bad how everything's impacted them. Some of these are juniors that are trying to get into college scholarship, and they lost about 4 or 5 months. And so I wanted to find a way to do it safe with, you know, COVID going on and under certain rules, but still make it competitive. And college coaches are telling me that stroke play and match play are both very important. So I kind of created a combo event, and I invited the top 30 high school golfers from Tampa Bay area down to Naples in Region 3. And so we started it off with stroke play qualifier at Heritage Oaks, cut it to 16, the Sweet 16. We played yesterday at Palmaire, got it down to the Final Four today. So we'll have the semifinals here at Laurel Oak. So I appreciate Laurel Oak, Palmaire, and Heritage Oaks being host. And then the last 9 hole will be match play for the finals. So we'll crown a champion. And then we have the consolation bracket, so those kids are still involved, so they have a chance to play for some.
Well, very impressive, Brian, to create a new event during a pandemic and bring people together from Tampa down to Naples. What was the hardest part of doing this whole thing?
Actually, probably the most anxiety was when everything under my control was working out, except for then all of a sudden a hurricane pops up. Oh, right. And so I was worried about weather, so I worked with the courses to see if we could play a little bit earlier, because it all has to flow. So if there's a rain out at any point, then it's like, how do you advance and get everything set up? So I'm, thank God that the weather's been okay so far and everything's gone. Friday was awesome. We had a 7-hole playoff. So the kids played 25 holes for the number 1 and 2 seed. And then there was, how fitting was it that there was 5 players vying for the last 3 spots. We had a playoff for all that shot 76. So the cut was 76. So that tells you the caliber, and then the medalist was 71.
Great golf, and the weekend worked out great. This is an inaugural event. You're hoping to do this annually now?
Yes, and I'm trying to set it up for the girls as well. So the girls are watching this and going, we kind of like this idea. So we're setting it up for Longboat Key in a month, and Longboat P has been gracious enough to hold it for the weekend there. So that's coming up in a month, so we're excited about that.
You know, it's so good to see these kids out here. They're good kids. They're young athletes. They're polite. It's kind of refreshing to see that, isn't it?
Yeah, they're just so polite. Mr. V, yes sir, you know, I want to make sure I'm doing things right. So they're not only good players, but, you know, respect, sportsmanship. That's what my series is promoting, is fun, competitive, but also respect and sportsmanship. These are kids that are going to be future leaders, hopefully, in our society, and we want to make sure that those are the kids we're promoting. So yeah,
they're on the way, it seems. Well, congratulations, Brian. A heck of an achievement to pull this off, an inaugural event, bringing the best high school golfers from Tampa all the way south to Naples.